Hey everyone, I hope you're all doing really well. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my 2020 makeup empties. I have been collecting all of my makeup products that I've used up throughout this year, and I did this last year as well. I thought it was a really great exercise to just really be able to reflect on how much I'm using versus how much I'm bringing into my life and just how much waste in general I create through my beauty habits. So I saved all of my makeup items. I do want to share with you each individual item category by category. And I have everything here with me for the intro. So I actually have everything in the same bag I had the products in last year. And you can see there's lots of items in there. I have a grand total of 40 makeup empties here with me that I'm going to be talking you through, letting you know some like mini reviews and thoughts and reflections on each of these products. So why don't we just hop on into that portion of the video. So we'll just kick it off with primers. I finished off four this past year, only one of them being full-sized, which is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Face Primer. This was the matte version. I'm happy I used this up because I don't really care for Wet n Wild as a brand, and I didn't really care for this product actually. It was a matte finish, although I wouldn't say it was like super drying or heavy by any means, but it did definitely just make my makeup look a little less dewy, and I didn't love that because I've been preferring a very dewy, natural kind of look, and I'm glad I used it up. I'm happy to have it out of my collection, but it's definitely not something that I would repurchase. I finished off also this Smashbox Photo Finish Primerizer. This is a mini, but it's half the size of the full size, so I did get a very good impression on this. I believe it's half the size. Yeah, it was half the size. So this is 15 mils of product, so I did get a really good impression on this. I got to really get to know the product, and I did enjoy it. I really liked mixing this with base products to give them more of a nourishing kind of finish and feel on the skin, but I wouldn't say that I love this any more than any other kind of moisturizing primer. It was a really good product and very comfortable product, but now that I've used it up, I don't really think I need to go out and repurchase a full size by any means. I also finished off a mini, like a deluxe, not even like a deluxe, just a sample size of the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer. I've said many times, this doesn't really leave any sort of impression on me. I don't really care for this product. It's that like slippy, silicone-y kind of texture, and I just don't really jive with it. But at the same time, I don't really think it's a bad product. It just isn't really my preference, but I'm happy to have used that up, as well as another sample size. This one was by Tatcha. This is the Silk Canvas. I did enjoy this product. I thought it was really comfortable on the skin and did definitely make my skin look nice and smooth, but it didn't really seem to be that much more impressive than other smoothing primers that I already own and that I've used in the past. So I didn't really feel the need to go out and purchase this or try this again, but I did enjoy it while I had it for sure. So four primers used up out of my collection. I'm really happy with that number. This next category is foundation, and I technically finished off four from my collection, even though we're just looking at three samples and a full-size tinted moisturizer here. I consider each of these samples as one in my inventory, so that's why I'm considering them as four makeup empties, because I just need those, like, for my brain, I'd like to have those numbers kind of correspond. So three of these are the Ilia True Skin Serum Foundation. I liked this, but this was one of those products that I kind of just wanted to use up because it was taking up so many numbers in my inventory, and I didn't really feel like I loved it. By no means did I hate it, because I was able to use off all three of these, and I did like the way that my skin looked when I wore it, but I don't really feel compelled to purchase a full size or to try this foundation again. The shade range on this is not great either. I'm not sure if what's on the back of the card is the full range of shades, but if this is just very dismal and really disappointing. So it's not really something I want to purchase in a full size, but I did finish off one full size base product, which I feel like I can't even believe that I only finished off one. This is the Ultra Repair Tinted Moisturizer by First Aid Beauty. This was in the shade Light. This shade range is not great, but Light was really good for me in the summertime. I found that this was just like the perfect shade. It really just looked like my skin. That's a given with the type of product it is, but the shade was really great for me as well. And I did like this. My skin looks super glowy and healthy and just like very natural when I wore this. So I did cut into it because I wanted to use up every last possible drop that I could. Some of it did get kind of dried up
after cutting it open, which is unfortunate. So that's why there's a little bit of product still remaining in there. It just got too thick to the point where I couldn't use it anymore. But I really did enjoy this. However, I won't be repurchasing it because the shade range isn't great. And I just feel like I really like the Bare Minerals Complexion Rescue so much more than this. And it does offer more shades. I really enjoyed this right from the beginning. I enjoyed this product, even though I was not intended to moisturizers when I brought this into my collection. So it kind of is what made me spiral and really just love more of a sheer look. This next category is concealer and corrector. So I have one full size concealer. This is like an extra large size concealer that I used up this year. This is the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. This has 15 mils of product, so it's half the size of a foundation. So it took me forever to use this up. I focused on this year, and then I had actually used it many times prior to having it in a project pan this year. So this lasted forever. I did end up taking out the stopper and taking out as much product as I could, and then I popped back in the stopper just recently for no real reason other than I still had it kicking around. But I did enjoy this. It is very, very full coverage without looking heavy or cakey on the skin. So I really, really did enjoy using this throughout this year, but I'm so looking forward to moving on to other concealers from my collection for sure. And then this is the Pixi by Petra Color Corrector. This is the only color corrector that I used up this year because it's the only color corrector that I had. And I don't really feel the need to pick up another one. Won't be able to use up any more color correctors seeing as I don't have any more and I don't anticipate myself picking up any more in the future. But when it comes to concealer, I see this number definitely going up next year considering that all of my other concealers are more average sized, and I can imagine I'll be able to use a handful more next year depending on how often I wear makeup. But yeah, I imagine this number definitely going up, but I'm really happy to see these both gone from my collection. I finished off two powders this year. This one I finished up a long time ago. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Powder for eye and face. This is in the shade One Fair. I finished this up very early in 2020, so I honestly had forgotten that I used this up. I had this in my 2019 project pan, and that was because it was my least favorite powder in my collection. I don't really love this. I think it looks nice. It's a very natural looking powder, but it just really didn't do anything for longevity. I love to set under my eyes where I put concealer because that's where I tend to crease the most and I see a lot of wear. And this didn't really do anything to really help with the longevity of my concealer or to like lock things into place. This also has a weird, like almost almondy, nutty kind of fragrance that I found a little bit off-putting. I love the packaging though, so I'm gonna hold on to this packaging because this just looks so luxe and it looks so pretty and it's very, very functional as well. Had a really nice sifter in it. So this was a good packaging, but product, not so great. I did also find that this Bare Minerals Mineral Veil actually was very, very comparable to the Charlotte Tilbury, funnily enough, now that I'm looking back on my experiences with both, because I found that this didn't really help to lock my makeup in place, but this was a really good finishing powder to just kind of like blur everything together and to make everything look uniform and just to kind of meld things. But I found, again, this didn't really lock my concealer into place. It did brighten up under my eyes nicely, but I need something that's a little bit more in high intensity for my under eyes. Last year, I counted my color complexion products all in one category. So I have my bronzer, blush, and highlighter empties all together. And that is five products that I used up this past year, which I'm really happy about. Obviously, two of these are just samples. So why don't we talk about those first? These are the Buxom Wanderlust Primer Infused Blush samples. I have the shade Dolly and Mykonos. These were really substantial samples, however, so this was a feat to get through, so I'm happy I got through these this past year. However, I would really like to get through one of my full-size blushes next year, if not maybe two full-size blushes. We'll see. Who knows? I really enjoyed this formula though, and these samples were very generous, so I actually got a really good impression on these, and I really did like the way that this formula blended and looked on the skin. This is one of the few times a sample actually like made me want to get the full size product. And then I have a mini of the Hourglass bronzer. This is the only bronzer I finished off in 2020, which I wish I had finished off more, but this is the Luminous Bronze Light bronzer. As you can see, I used up every last bit of this that I possibly could. It was a beautiful glowy bronzer and it just looked so amazing on my complexion, especially when I had more of a tan in the summer. I adored this so much. I'm so happy that I worked my way through this because this is an expensive product. Even this mini is over $30. And I enjoyed every minute of it, but I don't think I necessarily need to purchase a full size or replace this because I do think there must be a really good drugstore alternative out there somewhere. But I did love this. I loved it so much. And then for highlighters, I did finish off two highlighters, one being the ColourPop Super Shock Cheek in the shade Lunch Money. This is kind of like a creamy sort of formula. And I loved wearing this actually underneath of my foundation to just like brighten up my face before I put on complexion products, because this was a very light champagne-y kind of color, which could look a little bit frosty on my skin. So I really loved it as more of like a base luminous product. And then the other highlighter was a mini. This is the Fenty Beauty Kilowatt Highlighter in the shade Hustla Baby. This is a beautiful light gold shade, which I loved on my skin in the summer. I enjoyed this so much. It definitely is an intense kind of highlighter formula. It is blinding and beautiful though. I really did enjoy it. I was so happy to reach for this all summer long. I thought that this just looked so pretty. It was really, really beautiful, super easy to finish off because it was a mini and because it was just such a beautiful shade, but happy to have had it out of my collection. I would like to see this number improve next year and maybe use up some of my more full size, more substantial products from this selection of categories, but I'm happy to have used up 5 products and moved them out of my makeup inventory this year. For setting sprays, I only finished off 2 this year, and I actually used these both in a very similar way. So I used these both as a primer sort of product so that I would just kind of like refresh and hydrate my skin before going in with any of my base products. But then I also would just use these to kind of meld all my powder products together, just make my skin look nice and refreshed and happy. So the first one was the Mario Badescu facial spray with aloe, cucumber, and green tea. This is technically a skincare product, but I used it as a makeup product, like I said, because it's so high in fragrance. I just found that I would prefer it as a makeup kind of product. It really did help to meld down all of my powder products on my face and just make everything look nice and even, especially if I did go a little bit heavy-handed with like setting powders. This just melted everything together. I did enjoy it for that, but I don't see myself repurchasing this anytime ever because it wasn't amazing, but it was good to try it out. And then this is the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer Water. Again, I really did enjoy using this as a primer, but I really, really liked using this throughout the day when my makeup kind of was looking a little bit lackluster or maybe things just kind of fell out of place a little bit. I would spray this on my skin and then go in with a sponge and kind of just like blend everything back together. And this was amazing for intensifying eyeshadows as well, but I find I can do that with any setting spray. This was not the first time I used this either. I went through, I think, 2 or 3 minis of this prior to using this one up. So you can tell I really do enjoy this product, but I haven't repurchased it because I don't necessarily think that it's like the best ever setting or finishing spray. I don't really feel super compelled to these kinds of products anymore, but I did really enjoy it while I had it, and I enjoyed both of these. I worked my way through 3 brow products this past year. I count brow products as just like one category in my inventory, so let's just talk about all 3, even though these are 3 very different types of products. So this first one is the Jo Fresh Universal Brow Tint. This only came in 1 color, and Jo Fresh is no longer a line that's available anyways, I believe. But I did enjoy this a lot. I used this primarily for faux freckles actually when I had it, but I did really enjoy using it through my brows as well, closer to when I used it up. I did really like it. I thought it was really beautiful, but I can't imagine that a universal brow tint can actually be universal. I can't imagine this would work for everyone, but I did enjoy it while I had it. I had it for several years, and yeah, I thought it was a really great product, especially for faux freckles on my skin tone. It was amazing. It was like a marker kind of product, and yeah, just really, really good. I did enjoy it, but I don't really see myself purchasing any more brow markers in the immediate future. And then I also finished off 1 brow pencil. This was the only brow pencil that remained in my collection. I just don't foresee myself needing brow pencils anymore. I do think I go through them very quickly, and it's quite wasteful when I can use brow gels that last much longer or even just eyeshadow through my brows. But anyways, this was the Brow Wiz by Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is in the shade medium brown. It was really great for a micro brow pencil. No wonder why these are so hyped, and I have been through many of these in the past because they're just so good. But like I said, just don't think it's an essential step for me anymore. But I really did enjoy this product. And then one other brow product, this was a favorite of mine as well. This was the Kush Fiber Brow Gel in the shade Dutch. It was an amazing, like ashy kind of brown shade. I actually ended up taking out the stopper from this because I enjoyed it so much. And I don't think that that's something most people do with brow gels. I don't know that I've done it in the past either, but I really, really liked this. However, I do have some alternatives that are far more inexpensive that I think are just as good as this. So it's not something that I'm going to repurchase, but I really enjoyed it while I had it. It offered a really nice, fluffy, natural looking brow, but an enhanced perfected brow, if that makes any sense. Next up is eyeliner. I only finished off two eyeliners and they're both the exact same product. I had duplicates of this in my collection. This is the ColourPop Creme Gel Liner in the shade Exit. And you'd think because I finished off two that it was a favorite, but no, actually I really don't like the way that like matte white eyeliner looks on my eyes. I would only use this through the waterline and I just don't like it. I don't find that it is very flattering on my personal preferences. So I'm happy I used these both up, got them out of my collection, but definitely next year I'd like to improve upon this number and work my way through some of my colored eyeliners and liquid liners. Next up, let's chat eyeshadow. I lump eye primer and eyeshadow together. It's just the easiest for me. So this next product is the ColourPop Super Shock Shadow in the shade Hanky Panky. This is the only eyeshadow that I would consider as an empty because I did finish off eyeshadows in my Shade and Light eye palette, but I ended up decluttering that palette instead of considering it as like an empty palette because I didn't finish off the entirety of it. So in any case, this was the one and only eyeshadow that I did technically finish for this year. And it is a really nice, like cool to neutral mid-tone brown. I really did like it. And I actually really enjoyed using it most recently as a contour. It was so pretty as a contour, so I'm happy that I found that way to use it because that's how I ended up finishing it off. As you can see, there's a couple little things here stuck in the packaging, but they won't pick up on a brush, so that's why I ended up tossing it into my empties. This I was focusing on for the majority of this year and my 20 favorites in 2020, and I'm glad it's finally used up because it has been hanging on for so long. I thought it was so close to done. But it took forever. I used it as a brow powder, I used it as an eyeshadow, and as a contour, and it just got so multi-purposed. I'm so glad it was able to get used up prior to the end of 2020. And then the only other like eyeshadow type product that I finished off was an eyeshadow primer. This is the Matte Eye Primer in the shade Nude by Ulta Beauty. Really, really enjoyed this formula. I found that this was great because it was a tinted primer, so it did cancel out the veins on my eyelids, and this matte formula was perfect for my hooded oily lids. This is the most effective, inexpensive eye primer that I found. I really, really liked it, and when Ulta does come to Canada or begins offering Canadian, like shipping to Canadian addresses again, I would definitely pick this up once I've used up the other primer that I have in my collection because this was just really, really effective and inexpensive. I really did enjoy this. I did finish it off early in the year, but it's something that I have like thought about even since using it up because it was really good in my opinion. I finished off 8 mascaras this past year. I tend to go through a lot of mascaras, but actually 2 of these were colored mascaras, so I use them a little bit differently than I would use these, which were all black. So I finished off 2 of the ColourPop VFF Volumizing Mascaras in their colored versions. This first one is Purple Prose, and then this one was Yellow Goodbye. So I had these kicking around for quite some time, but I've come to realize that as much as they're fun to integrate into looks, I personally don't need this kind of product in my life because they just kind of hang around and I oftentimes overlook them and forget to integrate them into looks. So unfortunately, I didn't use these as much as I hoped that I would have. They ended up drying up sooner than the amount of use that I'd like to see out of them, but I'm happy that I did put them both into Project Pants this past year to really reach for them and make sure that I got some good use out of them. But yeah, I have come to realize this is just not a category I need in my life. Unless they, like, I would love to see brands come out with minis of colored mascaras as opposed to full sizes because minis, I would actually feel a little bit less guilty about like letting go bad, and I'd probably be actually able to use more of them up as well. I also finished off 3 CoverGirl mascaras. This first one was the Lash Blast Volume Fusion. I gotta say, it didn't really leave any sort of impression on me. I didn't really care for this. I just bought it because it was a water-resistant mascara that was on sale when I was going on vacation back in February prior to, you know, everything that's happened this year. But yeah, it didn't really leave any sort of impression on me. I actually found that I didn't love the way that this looked, but it was water-resistant. That's the reason why I picked it up. So it fit the bill for that. I also finished off this CoverGirl Supersizer Fibers Mascara. I did not like this. I didn't like this mascara. It was very dry right from the get-go, and this wand didn't really catch on my lashes as well as I'd like for it to, so it didn't really give me as much drama or volume or separation or anything as I'd like because it was very dry, and those bristles just didn't really do quite enough for me. I love this product though. This is the CoverGirl Clump Crusher. I got this one in the water resistant just because I like using this on my lower lashes. I do really like it on my upper lashes as well. This was like my favorite mascara when I was in high school, and so when CoverGirl went became cruelty free again recently, I needed to pick it up again and put it to the test. And I do love this product. I have another one of these in my collection currently, and it's something that I think I always want to kind of have one on hand of. I find that this wand is really good at separating my lashes and just giving me a really natural kind of look on the lashes. I just think it's really great, and I'm happy to have it back in my life after not using it for several years when I went cruelty free. And then I have 3 more high-end mascaras here as well. The first one I did get sent from Influencer, and I'm very grateful for that. This was the Fenty Beauty Full Frontal Mascara. I like the way that this looks on my lashes. I've said that many times on my channel. I love the way that this looks, but unfortunately, it just does not work for my hooded eyes. It just was really bad at transferring up on my hood. So unfortunately for that reason, I can't really recommend it for those of us with hooded eyes or anybody who has like deep set eyes. I feel like this would transfer on you as well. I loved the way it looked. I wish that it stayed that way and just like remained exactly as it applied, but unfortunately there was just too much transfer with that formula. And then this is just by far probably one of my favorite mascaras ever. This is the Milk Makeup Kush Mascara. I adore it so much. I just find that this gives me so much drama and volume, and it just looks so good on my lashes. They just look so dramatic and amazing, but I don't really want to go out and spend $30 on mascaras anymore. I just don't feel inclined to do that anymore. So unfortunately, I'm not repurchasing this for the time being. If you know of any drugstore alternatives to this or like any just more inexpensive versions of this, I would really like to hear your recommendations because I love the way that this looks. And I think last year I went through multiples of this because it was just so good. And then this was a new discovery this year, and I really enjoyed this one. This was the Ilia Limitless Lash Mascara. This is just a mini. I got this in a Sephora set a couple years ago, and I finally put it to the test. I loved this. So you can see this is a very spiky wand, and the bristles are just like perfectly spaced to evenly coat every single one of my lashes and separate them, and it made my lashes look so amazing and so full and fluffy all at once and just amazing. I loved the way that this looked on my lashes. I really, really enjoyed it, but again, it's expensive. It's a high-end mascara, and it costs very comparable to what the Milk one was, if not the exact same price, and I don't want to justify that right now, but wow, I really loved the way that this looked. I loved it so much. And the final category is lips. I finished off 6 lip products this past year. The first one was just a mini lipstick. This is the Charlotte Tilbury lipstick in the shade Pillow Talk. I really did enjoy this. This color was so nice. I did use this as a cream blush every once in a while, but this color was just very flattering on me. It's a very like brown toned rosy kind of shade. It was really, really pretty. And I do have another one of these that I'm going to eventually use up as well. But I don't think I would purchase the full size because although it was a beautiful color and formula, I just can't imagine that it's really worth the high-end price tag. You know what I mean? And then I finished off a lip liner by Bite. This is in the shade 018. And again, it was that kind of same shade, like a brown rose kind of shade. So it was just the perfect tone on my complexion and for my personal preferences. I used up so much of this. I sharpened it until I could no longer spin it in my sharpener, and I loved reaching for this, but I don't think that lip liners are an essential step for me either. I do enjoy them, but they're not something that I feel really drawn to ever really purchase, except this formula, because I did get this one. Did I get this one? I got one of these from Influencer at some point. I don't know if it was this exact shade, but I purchased many more since I got that one because I just loved this formula. It was so comfortable and just so perfect on the lips. It just glides onto the lips, but unfortunately Bite doesn't make these anymore, which I'm so disappointed about because this was just, yeah, so good. So good. Another Bite product, I don't know if they carry these anymore either. This was the lip primer, I think. This is the Line and Define Lip Primer. This was just a mini, but I had it kicking around for so long, I had to get it used up this year. I didn't dig into this product because I just didn't love it that much, but it was a like minty, balmy kind of primer. It was okay, but I don't see myself needing that kind of product in my life. So I'm happy I got it used up. And then three kind of lip gloss, lip oil kind of products. This first one is the Too Faced Sweet Peach Creamy Peach Oil Lip Gloss in the shade Pure Peach. I really enjoyed this. This was such a pretty peachy, corally kind of shade, and I loved the scent. It smelled like peach candies. It was so nice, but I don't foresee myself needing this in my life anymore. I prefer to just get lip glosses that are a little bit more on the natural kind of color. This definitely did offer more of a bright color than I would prefer, but I was really happy to use up this little deluxe size sample. It was really, really nice and comfortable on the lips. This next one is by Pacifica. This was the Enlightened Gloss in the shade Nudist. Gorgeous color, but not the best scent or flavor for sure. So definitely something to be weary of, but gorgeous, gorgeous color. I really enjoyed this on my lips. I thought that it was just the most flattering, like brown, pink, peach kind of hybrid shade. So beautiful. And yeah, I really love the way that it looks. This color was very comparable to the Fenty Gloss in the shade Fenty Glow, in my opinion, as well. So I really, really enjoyed it. But yeah, I'm not going to be repurchasing it because I didn't really find that I loved it or like need it in my life. But it was really good. And then the last lip product is the e.l.f. Tinted Lip Oil. This was in the shade Nude Kiss. It was a beautiful, like rosy red pink kind of shade with a very sheer color payoff. I loved this. I think this was the second one of these that I went through. I think last year I had one in my empties as well. And it was just a very addictive lip product that I could throw on at all times, like in place of a lip balm. And it just offered the perfect like finish on my lips that I could feel comfortable wearing like with a full face of makeup, but also I could just wear it without any makeup at all. Really great product. I definitely would consider purchasing another one of these in the future, but I do have some other lip glosses I want to work my way through before I bring that back into my life. So here's an overview of everything I used up in the year. This is a grand total of 40 makeup items that I used up from my collection. I know some of these are just deluxe size samples, but that's 40 items that were removed from my makeup inventory, which is amazing. I'm super happy to see all of these products making their way out of my collection. And I think that that's a really good number to kind of have used up in the past year. I foresee myself maybe being able to use up as many products next year or maybe something comparable to this number, but who knows? I'm really happy to see this many products making their way out of my collection though and to get used up in their entirety. I think this is great. I'm super impressed and really happy with this number.
I didn't pay retail for some of these products. Like some of them I definitely did get on a discount, but I did include all of the sample products as $3 flat just so that I had like some sort of dollar value for them, but I didn't really want to have to figure out their actual like value based on what the full size product is worth. I did that last year and that was just so tedious. I decided I'm not gonna do that again for the future. I just made it a flat $3 for those products. So those were all 40 items that I finished off in 2020. I really hope that you enjoyed looking through all of these products with me. I definitely feel like I have learned a lot about my makeup consumption by doing this 2 years in a row, but I do want to be a little bit better about what I consume and ensure that I'm not bringing in more products than I actually end up using throughout the year. So I think this exercise will really influence how I go about my low buy for 2021 and just my makeup consumption in general. I do want to talk about that in a different video. I don't really think that that's suited for today's video, but I really do hope that you enjoyed coming along and seeing all the products that I used up throughout this past year. It was very eye-opening, very interesting, and I do really enjoy watching these videos from other creators as well. So I will link some videos down in the description box if you'd like to see some other people who have recently posted their 2020 makeup empties so that you can compare and contrast or just kind of see what other people are using up. But yeah, that's going to be everything for today's video. Thank you so much for watching and for hanging out with me, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, everyone.